I'm never gonna forget Suzumi Bakuhatsu. Something like that.
You already forgot. Suzume is a character from 100.
Suzuki Bakuhatsu. I had the second one right. I'll never forget that Santa bananas.
Ah, yes, the character from No Goblin Game 3.
Santa bananas.
Santa bananas. Santa bananas.
Do we have a gallery of terrible movie stills?
Do we?
Oh, you need save data. Yeah. You gotta unlock that shit, son.
Of course I do, it's valuable.
More driving.
That's me.
That is you.
I really should have had Ogil play this since it's a sneaker's experience.
I want to play the mummy.
Oh, that's all yours if you want it.
I see that mummy coming up and I'm like,
My dashboard broke again, gosh.
We had better get you into shape, Stuart, if we're going to take on Falcon and return all the jewelry.
No, Robo Witch, we didn't play this mouse game earlier. We played a different mouse game. Where you had to check rats.
Check them rats.
What was it called? Sneakers?
Yeah.
Scary Dukes of Hazzard chips.
Okay, Stuart, the first thing we need to practice is your jumping skill. To jump, press the jump button.
Just
and
get
try
to the car so you can honk the horn endlessly.
So the car will honk its own horn endlessly.
Wait,
yeah.
I knew you could do it. If you press the jump button during the first jump, you will jump again while in midair.
Thank you.
Try this to jump over the next step in front of you.
You got this. I believe in you.
So this has to be like a 2002 game, right?
Is this PlayStation 1?
This is PlayStation 1, but it's gotta be real late.
Yeah, it's pushing. Already,
come over to me near the wall so we can continue your training.
Oh, she really phoned this in, didn't she?
No shit.
What's this for? No look up or down, and left and right are inverted.
Wow.
Oof. Oh, good.
Oh, great. See what an active camera does. Oh, Mario camera. I think I prefer that better.
Here's a skill you might find useful, Stuart. You'll be able to climb over this wall behind me if you use your double jump skill. You'll be able to grab the top of the wall and then climb up.
Here's a fun story. I worked on a pitch for a Stuart Little 2 game at Pandemic.
Nice!
We did not get it. Which was, I'm a little sad about. But it would have been pretty great.
Could it have beaten this? I mean,
yeah.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Nope, you had to get Army Men instead.
No, this was between Army Men and Destroy All Humans.
Ah.
Okay, even this camera is terrible. I'll deal with the wrong directions.
Oh, well, I think you're onto something with the Twitch chat getting too long. I refreshed it and suddenly all my dashboard stuff started working again.
I think that's it.
I think Chrome's just terrible.
I'm using Safari.
I think Safari's just terrible.
I think it's just Twitch chat
is terrible.
Being extremely long is bad.
Okay, how do I play video games?
I'm gonna do another poorly advised round of modding people in the chat. Because it's been a couple hours and I've seen a couple new names in there, so
you
I'm just gonna
have to defend yourself against.
Let's get some ops.
Yeah, it's gonna give you some ops in the chat.
Protect yourself. Small objects like this can be.
Don't worry,
up and
I'll never give
pressing
warp ops.
The throw button. So pick some up and try knocking out some of the targets.
We got $30 from Nicholas Randolph.
Ammo,
forgot to vote last time.
Some more.
Voting for Worms 30. Get it? 30 instead of 3D? Because I donated 30? I'll see myself out.
Thank you.
And we got $25 from David Pigupt. I'm already a Sarge Club member, but this seemed like a better way to vote than an email. My vote is for Mark Racer.
Nice. Thank you for double dipping.
Let me just push those donations, and we are good. I guess this
if you press and hold
tutorial is a good time
right
to do
together,
a vote roundup.
Mm-hmm.
We have, let's see, the vote tally so far is.
Try to shoot the flowers.
We have 12 votes for Shrek Extra Large, 7 votes for Crash Bash, 6 for Worms 3D, and Mart Racer, and Shrek Super Party.
If you press
and then
hold,
Jenga with 4, Pac-Man
right
Fever
together,
with 2.
Stuart's eyes.
So right now, Shrek Extra Large,
look and aim more,
pulling ahead of Crash Bash, but Worms 3D, Mart Racer, Super Party are still in contention.
Vicus, I've given you power. Please, please ban responsibly.
You can throw stuff now?
Apparently L2 and R2 is meant to do something here, but it is not doing anything.
It's making the game freak out.
What if you stand on that pad?
Yeah, you have to stand on that pad, right?
I would think you need to hit those things because they're kind of looking like targets.
Yeah, but I need to go into an aim mode, and aim mode is L2 and R2.
Mm. Oh, you threw
okay.
something? Oh.
Yeah, that's all
Wait,
right.
Wait, can you
do.
Hold like R2, hold it down, and then move the camera? Can that? Is that just rotating it?
Yeah, so like they're bound because I'm rotating the camera here. And it's not these, because these are...
You sure it's not? What's making you throw?
Let me read the instructions again. Hang on.
If you press and hold camera left and camera right together...
You'll see through Stuart's eyes.
Hold L2 and R2 at the same time.
You can use this view to look around more accurately with your throw attack. Try to shoot the flowers underneath the large tree to practice...
Nah.
That's sinister. Okay, so stand on the arrow.
Cast.
She's fine. She's scritchies. No scritchies. Okay, hold them both at the same time.
Yep.
And then use the camera stick.
You're not looking at the world through Stuart's eyes.
Yeah, what the fuck?
And like, yeah, like these are... I'm L2. This is R2. This is L2. So they exist.
Oh, suggestion. Is it reading right trigger and left trigger as a single access in the emulator?
Oh, it's direct input shit. Yeah.
That'll do it.
This is what you get for not checking all the gameplay, DM.
I'm sorry I didn't play every game for half an hour.
Shoulda.
Okay, well.
Can you just run around and do other stuff for the next 10 minutes?
Can I skip this tutorial? There we go, quit training.
Quit training, yeah, let's get out of here.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Cassie.
To remind of a direct input is a terrible API.
That's me.
Nice.
I have a nice sweater.
Okay, here I am.
You got the grape.
I am as big as this huge spider.
Oh,
that's
spider.
A black widow.
That is a massive black widow.
You should kill that spider so it doesn't kill everyone.
I got
it. Oh, never mind. It disappeared.
It just vanished.
Hey, Stuart. This looks tricky. I'll be very impressed if you can beat this challenge.
She licking you?
This is my
Here come the smooches.
This is my ship.
Oh, I spot a Draco. Time to mod up the Draco. Where'd you go? There you are. Come on.
Oh hey, it's Doritos the outcome.
Oh, I remember this from Donkey Kong 64.
Get all the bananas.
I feel like this game might not be terrible, it's just not, it's made for preschoolers.
It is rated terribly on the site Metacritic.com.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Some music.
Doing it. I'm living out my star dreams.
You miss.
I'm not very good at video games.
You just barely got it.
You suck!
You're so bad at stars!
You did it!
Congratulations, Stuart. You've completed the course.
Yeah, that's a good question. How many of those Metacritic users were preschoolers?
That's true.
Like, I feel like a lot of adults will look at games that are clearly intended for children and be like, this isn't for me, 1 out of 10. Like... I know it's not for you.
Stuart, I only need
like,
one
if you were like 4 or 5, like, I don't know, this is passable. You're a mouse, you're picking up goldfish crackers. Wait, are those actual goldfish crackers?
We should have put this
in the
spell.
Oh man, we should have slotted this into the, yeah.
Look in the left corner when you pick it up. That's just a goldfish cracker. That's just a picture of a goldfish cracker.
It doesn't really control that well. Mm. It's a PS1 game in 2002.
Oh, yikes. Wow, really? Mm-hmm. I was gonna say, like, late 90s PS1 game, but 2002, oof.
Like, this game came out...
Well, I don't want to defend it. I'm not gonna defend it. It's not very good. I feel like...
Although by 02, the PlayStation was pretty much put to bed.
Like, I totally get, like, games targeted at kids getting an unfair rap, especially from reviewers sometimes.
Yeah, and, like, honestly, I don't know, if you were, like... 3 or 4 years old in 2002 and your parents had a PS1. This would be all right.
Do I want to visit my old pal Snowbell?
Yeah, sure.
Isn't that the cat? I don't think you want to visit Snowbell.
We have some donations.
Ooh. Let me get on that. Oh yeah, I dragged this into a different window hoping it would stop breaking the back end.
Look at Snowbell.
Oh, this is the level...
Oh, level select, okay.
Oh, okay.
Oh, so but you need rings.
I ride the cat to get me to the different levels.
Nice.
Okay, we've got $20 from Tom... I'm sorry if I butcher your last name. We've got $20 from Tom Fulgione. That seems right. Busy running my own extra live streams, but I always love your work. Keep it up.
Thank you.
And we've got $42.00. Nice, that secret weed number from Zane Zero. Thanks for streaming strange and or bad games and making cool ones. Throwing my vote towards Crash Bash because I need to remember that game and everyone needs to see those bad mini games.
Yes, Crash Bash.
We've got $4.20, nice weed number. From Oliver, I'm so sorry if I butcher your last name. Thielen, Ganbate, Gan, Ganzer, and Grenz. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Also, this game was a full $60 game.
Yikes! Oh. Wow, my sympathies.
Out the fucking window.
Quickly leaving.
Holy shit.
Yeah, for the PlayStation 1 in 2002.
You can get that toilet
That's
paper.
Rough,
yeah. Oh, Spider-Man.
Spider-Man.
Pictures of Spider-Man.
Just looking at it without thinking about any of those extraneous factors, though, I feel like as a little kid experience, it's fine. Though that fucking bird face is creeping me out. That would probably terrify me if I was a little kid.
Find your eyes, have no soul.
Please help.
Need to find the key to get the jeweled ring. Excuse me, Spider.
Whoa, Spider said, fuck off. Are those books just floating in the air?
Open that suitcase. Somehow. There you go.
Had an ice cream in it.
Look through the eyes of Stuart Little. Experience the life of Stuart Little.
What do your mouse eyes see?
God, this game's really... That wall. Man, they have so many fucking bugs in their house!
Call the exterminator.
For real, and get rid of that rat, too.
Also sentient robots. Wait, are we the rat? I thought he was a mouse.
He's a mouse.
Okay, well, he gotta go when the exterminator comes, too.
No, he's Stuart Little. He's the family saved him. Mm. He's a little orphan mouse and the family saved
him. Look, you can't call an exterminator and say, oh yeah, kill the pest except for this one pest. That's okay.
This is a true pet, a true friend of the little family.
I mean, it's probably pretty easy if you're like, don't kill the one wearing a sweater and pants. Like, he'll probably be like, don't kill the one that can talk.
Maybe that's why they don't call an exterminator for all these fucking black widows. They're just like, all right, we'll keep the deadly spiders because that means we get to keep our rats on.
Okay, buddy, what's your name?
Woohoo! George has left his toy springs out. You can jump on them to
What's the name of the McDonald's early breakfast bird?
Oh!
Birdie.
I think it was Birdie.
Yeah, it was Birdie.
I love her. Was it last year that we had sexual grimace somewhere in the stream?
I don't know. That's some stupid thing that came out of my mouth during the Saints Row Let's Play.
Okay, that's where it's coming from. It was in my brain somewhere.
Wow, look, a balloon, Stuart.
That's a good point. This family also has a bird in their house.
That's true.
When I'm playing video games, Glenda, words just come out of my mouth and I don't know what they are. Like Hogs Fatman. Like, I have no control over it.
Restart point.
Yeah, that's where I want to restart point.
Excuse me. Don't despair, y'all. Up next is The Mummy featuring your friend Oatmeal Raisin going on some kind of sand adventure.
Excellent hunting, Stuart. You have found a face block.
I did.
Why are there blocks floating in space? This fucking world's weird.
Oh, I see. I just hold on to it.
So many birds.
It's just one bird. She's just in many places.
That's one of our horns.
Yeah, it is. From our free horn pack.
No, those horns are very expensive.
From our expensive horn pack.
From our expensive horn pack.
Top dollar you spent on those sound effects.
Okay, tell me how you open this case.
Now that's something special. Red suitcases contain extra
lives.
Says,
they contain extra lives. Like,
the stream, get it?
The stream. You can donate now at Sarge.club.
Vickis says that he probably shouldn't give this poor voice actor so much shit because she was probably paid in goldfish, TM.
For real.
I'd be pretty upset if I was paid in goldfish.
I can live with it.
Yeah! I found the golden key! Now all I have to do is take the key to the golden suitcase.
What an adventure! This is cutting out to me!
Oh my god!
Yeah, this game isn't offensively bad, chat, but I would say for $60 in 2002...
On the PlayStation 1?
This is kind of offensively bad for that. Let's see what else $60 could have bought us in 2002.
Well, $50.
$50, whatever. Full price for a video game.
Okay, so that's the bookshelf hell.
Alright, I'm scrolling through this and I'm already not super, super excited. Well, I guess you could have gotten Guitaru Man.
Really? Those no-good games came out in 2002?
Up to February. Could have bought Fatal Frame 1.
Well done, Stuart.
That game's alright.
You've collected enough rings to open up level 2.
Visit Snowbell, he can wow, 2002 is pretty... Oh wait, you could have bought Army Man RTS!
It's a good video game. You could have bought Army Man RTS. The classic, best, and 17th Army Man game. Or maybe it was like the 21st. It's up there.
It was our 2-hour special.
You could have bought Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind instead of this game. You could have bought Grand Theft Auto 3.
I can watch the movie.
What are you doing? I'm not doing anything.
Oh my god.
Get the book. This is cool.
Could have gotten Neverwinter Nights instead of this game.
This kid's have to be in their 20s now.
Yep.
Those kids have died of old age. Feel old yet?
Millennials just ruining building houses everywhere with their planes.
Animal Crossing for the GameCube you could have bought instead of this, which I'm gonna argue would probably be a way better purchase for a little kid.
Yeah.
Kingdom Hearts, the original one.
Oh my god.
Could have bought that instead of this. I think it just needs the context to make this game really bad. You could have bought Super Mario Sunshine for your kid instead of this game.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, I found the one. You could have bought GTA Vice City because that came out the same year this game did.
Well, not for a kid.
Whoa!
Oh, no!
Jeez! Holy fuck. Is everyone okay? Did everyone survive that?
We got $25 from William Crawford. I love my little rat son. Also A+ on 100 foot.
Thank you. We appreciate it. Thank you. Our voices are just getting tired.
Oh yeah, I got coffee while I was driving and I completely forgot about it. This is the cutest coffee cup ever.
Isn't it cute? That's the 1970s Aperture Science cup.
I love it.
I can't remember if this is 60s or 70s. It's 70s.
What happens if you get 80 coffee. Goldfish?
Dan knows that I like my coffee like a child.
Deliciously.
Just full of sugar and milk.
Only available to drink once you find the gold key that opens the gold suitcase.
Oh my god.
Okay.
This game is looking like late night porn on a bad cable.
Damn!
A speedboat, Stuart.
Woohoo.
Oh.
Ooh.
Oh yeah.
Oh, it looks like you've hit the emulation error zone.
Uh-oh.
Oh yeah.
Oh no, it just looks this bad. Okay.
No, this is definitely.
Maybe a little of both?
Oh.
No, it's
No, this is how it's supposed to look. I'm willing, the water.
You know what?
And the horizon and buoys.
I think it's just this bad.
Yeah.
I'm making a decision.
I think it's just that interesting look rough. Okay.
Rainbow! I need this cough drop, you guys.
Yeah, this is basically just the jet ski from Crash, but awful.
Yeah.
I do like that he's just got one hand on the wheel. That's how you know he's a cool mouse.
Chat says, I would get this game for my child if I wanted to passive-aggressively signal that I was disappointed with them.
Oh.
Same. $25 from Hannah Fowell. Please do not buy Vice City for children. Thank you, Hannah.
Yeah, thanks, Hannah.
Well, you get Animal Crossing for the kid and Vice City for yourself.
Someone gift that fucking emulation error. Pushing that. When I got Vice City, I was 14 at that time.
Oh my god.
In 2000, yeah, I was.
Fantastic. 02.
Maybe I was 15. I turned 15 that year.
You've been awarded a jewel ring for completing.
I really wanted that game for my birthday. And my dad did this whole thing where he's like, I looked up that game you wanted, and did you know there's cocaine in it, and drugs, and violence, and guns? And
And you're like, yeah, that's why I want
to
play it.
So I hadn't been allowed to play games with guns in them, like, my childhood, and through my whole childhood. And he was like, this is unacceptable, I won't get this for you. I was so devastated. And then, on my birthday, he pulls out Vice City, and I was like, what? He's like, I was kidding. So my dad owns.
That's so cute.
Yeah, I would have been 14 in 02, so you would have been 15.
Yeah.
I remember
my first run of Vice City. That was a good game.
Good game.
Vice City was banned in the country that I was living in at the time, so I had to import it from New Zealand, and it was like a week after it came out in the US, and I wanted to play it so bad that I started having like sleepwalking episodes where I thought other people were in Vice City, and it was weird.
Wow.
You can do it, little mousy.
I don't know if I'm meant to do it this way.
Whoa! Oh man, we're discovering exploits. Is this how speedruns work?
Yeah, so that saves about 10 minutes on the route.
Saves so many screens, so many frames. Kill all the animals, including Stuart.
There's a bug. Kill the bug. Buggy's dead.
Kill bug.
Like, in terms of, like, on the Sarge Club scale, this isn't that bad.
No.
No.
Honestly. It's just kind of boring. Mm. But, like, it's not that bad. We got to have discussions about Vice City, what we were doing in 2002.
It's not, like, offensively bad, but the context really doesn't help it.
Chat wants to know if you either A, shot anyone, or B, dealt cocaine in your sleep when you were thinking about Vice City.
What's the statute of limitations on that?
In Australia? I don't know.
I don't know, like a week?
Oh, that's just a red... That's just the red hexagon. My bad.
You're coming up on time.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop it in 3 minutes.
You found the sandcastle!
Kill animal.
Oh, excuse me. Can we walk back and just get a good eyeful of? Oh, Jesus!
Make him wobble.
What is he doing?
He's die, wobbling. He's
die,
stunned.
Die.
Is he okay?
Gave that bird a case of the wobbles.
This music is a nightmare. Darken, please do not give your child Stuart Little 2 for their birthday. The cops will come with the copy.
I like the suggestion that Darken just gets his kid GTA 5 and says, just kidding.
Guys, I think I'm going to save Stuart Little.
Why the fuck not?
Oh, this is the boat trip again.
Wait, the bird came back.
Yeah,
bird's telling you, you want to go on a boat trip?
Here comes another fucking bird.
That's the same bird. We're going in circles.
Yeah.
Why doesn't the yellow bird come yell at the black bird and tell it to fucking not peck your eyes out? Like, I don't...
You think a canary can stand up to a crow?
I don't know. Canary gets...
I don't fight birds against each other. I could.
A leaked bird ring. Bird fight.
Where does the secret block go? Oh, in the fountain.
Excellent hunting, Stuart. You have found a face block.
No, oh, just like
this voice
six
actress
more.
Is not interested in her life.
Oh my god. Six more of those things?
Spoilers, I am not going to be collecting six more of those things.
Toughest being the difference between the music for this game and the difference in the music for Banjo-Kazooie is that this is not the Teddy Bear Picnic, which is the only music which is in Banjo-Kazooie and is amazing because of that. Please do not come to Panzer's Cockfight Extravaganza. You will be disappointed. Or titillated.
Okay, I'm gonna climb this pole and then I will put the loading screen up. Look at this.
You won the game.
Oh, Dup's telling us that the user ratings are actually better than the critic ratings for this game.
Huh. Makes sense.
There's a barrel.
62 critic ratings, 7.6 user.
One day all this will be yours.
I love those fucking trees in the background that are like one polygon.
Look at the barrel of leaves that are just like one single layer.
Ugh. We're free.